I have one John tell you about the event. I got another John help me out from the Park District. John, this is really unique. Walk us through what's going to be happening here.
Yeah, so the Chicago Park District's Movies in the Parks is hosting our very first ever multi-screen, multi-day outdoor local film festival. We're going to have dozens of local films over the next 3 nights. We'll have filmmaker fireside chats and campfires and other programming and free popcorn, of course, all right here in Ping Tom Park.
All right, and let's talk about the park here for a second because it is an absolutely gorgeous park. If people haven't been there, what a great opportunity tonight in the next few days to explore this park.
Yeah, it's a beautiful park right on the river in Chinatown. Gorgeous landscaping and structures. It's just one of my favorites.
And it's even better to look at from our Jam drone cam. It looks incredible here this morning. You're going to have great weather all the next 3 days. But one of your partners that you're working with here is Free Spirit Media. So Yarnami, you're here with the organization. Tell people what Free Spirit Media is if they don't know.
So Free Spirit Media is a not-for-profit organization that helps the youth get involved in the TV and film industry that they normally wouldn't have the opportunity to do.
And that's really important. And I imagine an event like this, Daniel Shea, is a really great exposure for everyone and the organization.
Yeah, especially for the youth because they can share their pieces that they created, and that way they can share it with the community and churches and just get everybody in the know.
Now, I got to say that the films seem like a great reason to come on out here, but John mentioned something about free popcorn, so I got to ask him about that. So free popcorn going on?
Free popcorn. We provide free popcorn at all of our movies in the parks, and this is no exception.
And the whole event is free, right?
The whole event is totally free. We'll be here the next 3 nights, 7:30 to 10:30, right here in Ping Tom Park.
And I got to say, I've actually never been to Ping Tom Park. How is it even possible being someone that's lived in Chicago for so long? It's a great place, and really the weather's going to be gorgeous the next couple days to coming out. So what do you guys think about free popcorn, right?
We love it.
And all the films, too. It's really important. Here to talk about one of the films is one of the directors, Camby. How you doing this morning?
I'm doing great. How you doing?
So you're the director of The Exchange, which for people that haven't seen or heard of the film, man, it is a really cool story. Walk us through the documentary that you directed.
Yeah, The Exchange is about 5 students from the South Side of Chicago who obtained passports and went to an art festival in Germany with the artist from Chicago by the name of Theaster Gates. The art festival was called Document of 13.
And how long did it take to produce this film?
It took 2 years to produce and then another year to edit the film. So
it's 5 guys from the South Side, and anyone that travels know the impact that can have on you. I imagine that that was what the story really unfolds, is like seeing how people change when they travel abroad.
Yeah, I mean, it's really about the impact of traveling and what that did to the students here who had never traveled outside Chicago, so it was really an impactful film.
So your film is up at the film festival tomorrow night. Yeah. What does that mean to be able to be shown in a park here in Chicago? What does that mean to you?
I mean, it means a lot for people in the city of Chicago to see, like, these kind of things and how the impact of, like, traveling could have on students here from the South Side.
Yeah, and that's amazing, and I can't wait to see the film. And we got to talk to John a little bit from the Park District about the whole festival because it's 3 days, dozens of films, and it's at this gorgeous park, right?
Yeah, this beautiful Ping Tom Park right in Chinatown. It's the first time we've ever done a festival like this. We're very excited.
And for people that haven't been to the park, I mean, what a gorgeous place. I think we can maybe take a look at the Jam drone can. You can just see, it's just an incredible view. You got the river right here. What a backdrop for a film festival.
Yeah, it's a beautiful park. It's got a lot of natural beauty, and we're really excited to fill it with local film. And you got the river and the bridge, and it just looks beautiful.
All right, so Cam, you were not here when we were talking earlier. There's free popcorn too. Okay. You all about that?
I'm all about the popcorn. Got to put the butter, you know.
Wait, is it free butter?
No butter.
No butter. All right, never mind. Shut it down. Cancel it. No butter. No, guys. We're relaxing right now. This is what you should be doing at the festival here tonight and for the next couple nights. And one of the films features one of our own very known neighborhoods, Rogers Park. Kyle, you're the director of the film. And we were joking earlier, you live in Rogers Park. But this is a critically acclaimed film, 100% on Rotten Tomatoes. Been in New York, L.A., and now, I guess, coming home to Chicago tonight. Talk about the film.
Yeah, it's a film about two interracial couples going through midlife crisis. I'm of a certain age, so I know a little bit about that.
What's that, 32 years old?
Yeah, a little bit over that.
Okay.
But yeah, and it's a film that really features, I think, the diversity of the neighborhood. We had race and gender blind casting for this film. We work with 4 Chicago actors to help put the film together. It's funny, it's sad, there's a lot of screaming, because that kind of happens in midlife too.
Right, exactly.
So it's a great show.
I got a lot to look forward to, I guess.
Yeah, you do, and it'll wake you up. We're at 9 o'clock at night, so don't go to bed.
All right, sounds good. Well, the film looks great, and I think, but is it cool to come back to Chicago and show the film here in this park?
Oh, totally. This is one of the last screenings before it'll be on Amazon Prime in October. So we're really happy to kind of bring it home and show it for free. here, you know, for the citizens again.
All right, and we're at Pingtown Park. Really quickly, John, public transportation is a great opportunity for people that want to do that, too.
Yeah, public transit is great. The closest L stop here is the Red Line at Cermak Chinatown. It's about a 3-block walk, so totally doable.
Yeah, and we can see the Orange Line tracks from the drone Jan Cam. You can go to Halsted, maybe, or even over to Roosevelt, but Red Line's the best way to do it. We already got people reserving their spots here. They got their popcorn. They're ready, by the way. No butter. BYOB. Bring me your own butter if you want some on the popcorn. All right, the next film we're going to talk about is The Spy Who Knew Me. I got Lawrence, I got Katie, and Lucy, the director, the producer, and the star of the film. Walk us through, Lawrence, what the film's all about.
It's a James Bond-style spy thriller starring 20 actors with Down syndrome as they investigate the connection between diamond heists in the city and a missing persons case.
And I got to say, Katie, for artists breaking limits and expectations, Abel's the name of the film crew that you guys do.
Yeah.
What does it mean to the organization and to the film and the stars to be able to show it in the park?
It's really wonderful to be able to connect with our community and to show some different sides and personalities of the actors that we work with. We had a lot of organizations that made the movie possible, so it's great to bring it back to the community that helped us make it.
All right, and we got one of the stars here. Lucy, how you doing this morning?
Good.
All right, so Lucy, was she a little bit of a diva here on the show?
No comment.
No comment. All right, so Lucy, you start on the show, you knew all your lines. What is your character? What does she do?
General Becca Hamilton. And she's the head of Interpol, and she cannot wait to drop the hammer on the bad guys.
Head of Interpol, and she drops the hammer on the bad guys. That's awesome. And I imagine Lucy was a great representation of all the actors and actresses in the show.
Yeah, we have 20 actors in our regular teen ensemble of all different abilities. Lawrence wrote individual characters for each one of them based on monologues that they wrote themselves. So you'll get to see them each talk a little bit more about who they are.
It's an awesome organization. Great films. Just one of the many great films happening here over the next 3 days.